Hi, everybody. Rhys Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
We're in Moscow, Idaho for another great game inside the Kibbe Dome.
Mitchell is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started.
Warren takes it at the four, across the 30, and he's tackled at the 32-yard line.
Hall's proved in the past, Kirk, that when he's at home, he's so much more comfortable, the whole routine all week long, and it makes him play better on Saturday.
It does. I think there's a difference between him on the road and him playing at home. And I don't know if it's just that home-cooked meal or just being around the familiar atmosphere here at this stadium, but he does seem to play at a different level. And it's going to be a challenge for this defense to be able to stop him this week.
He gets hit out of bounds at the 39. Conley gained 7 yards on that play. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line.
Good, solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
He gets to about the 27-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 27. Pushed out of bounds at the 17. Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big gain.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice gain for the offense.
Now he tries to buy some time. What a play, and that is first and goal.
They've got the defense on their heels now. It's first and goal.
Ball on the 2. Makes the PAT. A nice six play, 68-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart up. It can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Idaho to kick. Douglas from the 1. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back.
Personal foul. Clipping. Receiving team.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
From their own 11-yard line. Second down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Throws into coverage, it's picked off. Tackle made at the 23-yard line.
Personal foul. Clipping. Offense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. From the 38-yard line, first down. Idaho up 7 points. Tackle
tackled outside after a nice pickup. Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Offense.
That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. It's first down and a lot. The Vandals defensive back left earlier with an injury. They need him back out there because right now the offense has been on his replacement. They run it left.
He's at the 40. He's at the 30. For the 20. For the 10. And he will score.
Point. Adams is the kind of player that keeps defensive coordinators up late at night, Herbie. I mean, if you load the box and take away the run, he's going to go up on top. If you sit back in the zone, he'll kill you with his legs. I mean, he's a great player.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 30.
Ball State's got a new coach at the helm here in this one, Herbie, and you got to wonder what kind of impact that's going to have. Players will always want to sell out for a new coach, so I expect an emotional game and a lot of big play. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Got the corner. Martin picks up five with the carry. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Brought down around the 38-yard line. Brown is waiting for the snap. Tackle made to the 38-yard line. The Vandals really could have overlooked this team today, I think, very easily, but they haven't done that so far.
No, you can't take anybody too lightly, and they've obviously not done that. They come out of the gate today and really put a lot of points up on the board.
And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns in 2 possessions. To that quickly. He's taken down right around midfield. That makes it first and 10. From midfield, first down. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he's taken down at the 38.
Well, as you just saw right there, the screen pass can be a very effective weapon for an offense, especially when they're disciplined and when the receivers are patient.
Here's an opening, the 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. A quick update now. Here's Reed.
The midshipmen took the field ranked 11, but hoping an impressive win could move them into the top 10. And for Navy, they jump out in front. Navy on top, 10-6.
A 3-touchdown difference here. Reed 21-0. Yates gets set to kick this one away.
sends it sailing downfield. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line.
Idaho's got people flying all over the field on defense right now.
Boy, they sure do. Right now, we're just seeing great defensive effort. They have a plan. They understand it. They're playing with great speed, and they're not giving up big plays. That's why they're playing well up to this point.
It was a quick three and out on their last possession.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Quick throw to the tight end, and they make the stop at the 26.
Gain of nine on the play. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. And he just gets rid of it. As we expected coming into this game, this one appears to be under control. Idaho's got a three-touchdown advantage. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain of 7 yards. First down.
From their own 33-yard line, it's first down.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
Carries the ball for a nice gain. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay.
That'll bring my second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up. Drive.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. They go with a toss. Nice run to the left there.
That's a deal of 6 yards. First down.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Right around the 32-yard line.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
Smith was the intended receiver on the play.
And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. And down he goes, right around the 26-yard line. Smith gained 6 yards with a short completion. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He launches one for the end zone. And he's all the way in for the touchdown.
This guy.
guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
They rolled the dice and went for it on fourth, and I'm sure they're happy with the result. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Ball State lines up for the kickoff. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Nice run, and he's brought down. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He's at midfield. At the 30, to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Vandals.
Wow, he looked like a running back out there. And that's just what you want when you're calling the option.
And he hits the PAT. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
Let's take a look at what's going on in the top 25. This one's been entertaining us all day long. The Horned Frogs strike through the air, getting into the end zone for a touchdown, nearing the midway point.
All right, thanks, Reese. Back to the live action here. Idaho gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 23.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of a blowout. Here's the throw. I don't think he got anything on that. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Second down and six. Ball on their own 26. Straight in the middle, and he meets the defense. They need to do a better job of managing the clock here.
You're right, Fred. Not only was that a horrible play in terms of yards picked up, but also, as you mentioned, in terms of all the time that may be wasted.
Throws out to the running back, no good. And that'll bring up a punting situation.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
This is a great punt-blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. Warren fields it at the 39. He makes it out to midfield. Paul's play so far, Kirk, is really what we expected. I mean, I don't think we're shocked at all at how well he's playing right now.
Isn't it fun when a plan comes together for an offense?
Exactly.
I mean, speaking as a quarterback, I mean, this guy has really gone out there and executed this plan. Now, there's still a whole other half to go, but up to this point, he's made good decisions, he's taken care of the football, and he's leading this team. And that's really all you can ask of him.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line.
Black five!
They'll bring him down right around the 42-yard line.
That'll bring up third and two.
He's at the 30. He's at the 20. And he scores. Touchdown. Three rushing touchdowns on the ground today for this young man.
You've heard the saying, a guy's in a zone. Right now, this guy's not stopping for anybody.
He makes the PAT. It was a quick three-play, 50-yard drive, and the result, 7 points. Yates has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. It's 52 at the 30. Across midfield, looking for the corner to the 20, the 10, and a huge touchdown play. Boy, is this kid electric! Converts the extra point. Ball State is ready to kick it away. He's out to the 30. He got hit hard. The Vandals are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
He's at midfield. Tackle made around the 39-yard line.
What a run by the quarterback.
Well, this guy is dangerous. He can hurt you by running or throwing. There you can see how talented he is as a runner. Play breaks down. He didn't panic or get flustered. He just tucks it in and picks up a nice game.
Now he tries to buy some time.
And they get the sack.
Hey, kill. Where?
That brings up second and 13.
Now he's scrambling. He's tackled around the 33-yard line.
Hey, kill. Where?
Going deep. Doesn't get there. The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. He gets it up, and it's good. With only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime, I would expect they'll just squib kick this one. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And he's tackled around the 26-yard line. That's going to do it for the first half, and they're just trying to keep this thing close. The Vandals with a 24-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports Halftime Show. Reese Davis and David Pollack here at the break. David, you go through this first half, and there was a lot of anticipation for this game coming in, but it sort of got sleepy. It was sort of as scripted throughout the first half. What's it like for a player when a game's sort of gone flat on you to try to maintain that edge?
Well, you always have so much emotion and so much excitement coming into a ball game, and a lot of times it's about tapering it down and making sure you don't use it all in the first half. I think you saw the feeling out process, and now in the second half, you'll start to see that energy pick back up, because now you're going to see the goal in sight. The finish line's coming, and guys are going to make sure they want to make plays.
I have to try to maintain a fine balance between the desire to make plays and staying within yourself, sticking to the game plan, and perhaps that will be the key to the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
He's taken down at the 39.
That's good for a gain of 14 yards. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 39. Quick pass.
This is smart, efficient play calling. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
That brings up second and 5.
He's going to air it long. And he's taken down
right around the 18-yard line.
Good-looking play there.
I think they did a great job up front here, allowing the quarterback enough time to look downfield and spot the open man.
So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10.
Much room there as they try to work the left side.
That makes it second and 10.
And he gets a yard on the run.
Here's third and 9. Ball on the 17-yard line.
Catches it, and he's punished. It's up, and it's good.
And ready for the kickoff.
From the 8-yard line. And he's tackled at the 30.
Now, they practiced all week this week, and they told us yesterday, Brad, that they felt pretty good about what they put in, the plan that they had. And I think now that you see them playing today, it's no wonder they felt so good.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again.
Makes it out to about the 49. From their own 49-yard line, first down. Tackles him hard at the 34. He's on the run. He's at the 20. And that sets them up with a first and goal. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. They'll work the left. And they make the stop.
Around the 10-yard line.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
That brings them second and goal.
He's on the run. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown.
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
And he tacks on the extra point.
A five-play, 71-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
You know, this offensive line has done a really good job, but really, I think it's more about the big play ability from the running backs and why we've seen so many big plays from this offense.
He just drills this one.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Not a whole lot's been working for them so far. They should just come out and play loose and easy because they've got nothing to lose.
From
their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Throws, and it's knocked away.
He threw that to a guy who was well covered and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball was only tipped.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. Brought down right around the 32-yard line.
That brings up fourth and three.
Brown awaits the snap. He's taken down at the 40.
They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in 6.
Idaho
up big. Play action here. He's going to scramble. Tackle right around the 50.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
From midfield, it's first down.
Down he goes.
Around the 40.
That'll make it second and inches.
Two tights.
Four down.
Against the mic.
Red 2.
Motion. Yellow 3.
Motion.
Yellow 3. Right.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. From the 35-yard line. First down.
Conley gets the call again. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
That's 3 down. Idaho's got a huge lead. Just about set to start the fourth quarter, mercifully.
Here we go.
Here's a running play.
Makes it out to about the 19.
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 19.
Idaho in control.
Red 2. Blue 20.
Motion.
That's a great tackle at the 5-yard line. Away from him, touchdown. What a game this kid's having. Four rushes have ended in touchdowns.
We wondered if the linebackers were going slowing down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Yates gets set to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And it'll be interesting to see how much fight this team has left in them. This has been a brutal game. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He throws a dart to the right.
Hey, that's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
Makes it to the 28-yard line.
That brings us fourth and seven.
Warren is back deep to return the punt. Oh, he got nailed on that one. Idaho's proven to be the better team in every facet of this football game.
Boy, their defense has played lights out. Their offense is taking advantage of their opportunities. Everything has led them to a very comfortable lead.
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injuries.
He's at the 40. Inside the 30. Very clutch tackle there because this kid had some space. And 10 following that big run. Idaho with a big advantage. He steps out at the 17-yard line. He makes the PAT. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Horned Frogs came into the game ranked 7th. They're now bungee jumping, and the cord's going to break. And for Navy, they've won 2 straight. The Midshipmen win it by 14.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
I don't expect any once-in-a-lifetime rallies here, but that being said, we could still see some exciting plays.
And he carries the ball for a nice game. So it's second down now.
4 yards to pick up the first. Tackle made around the 45-yard line.
Slaughtered on the tackle at the 45-yard line. That makes it first and 10.
Just under 3 to go in regulation. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. He's tackled at about the 49. Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
15 on the play. First down.
From the 36-yard line, first down. Up the fumble, and he's level at the 41.
Great example of an opportunistic defense coming up with the fumble.
And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
He's at midfield. And he's tackled around the 39-yard line. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. A little over a minute in the game. They'll bring him down at the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Gets out to around the 22. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Vandals know that they have to enjoy this guy while they've got him, because somewhere down the line he's going to be at the next level.
Well, that'll definitely be in his future, but for now he needs to sit back and just enjoy this performance, and really the play caller, the quarterback, the offensive line, the receivers, the entire group as just a whole should feel good about their performance.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.